From the Scripps Studios, this is 10 News.
Hello there, I'm Virginia Chow with this 10 News update. It was a long night for workers at the Registrar of Voters office. Voters waited hours in line to cast their ballots. The last person in line voted about 11:36 last night, but he wasn't even the last one out of the booth. There were a few voters who went in before he did, but took their time and didn't get out until after midnight. At least one person waited 4.5 hours to vote yesterday. Everyone who was in line by 8 p.m., though, got to vote last night. Happening today, a protest against recent program cuts at the Sweetwater Union High School District. After budget miscalculations, the district is cutting adult classes, several after-school programs, summer school, and a Mommy and Me class. The district miscalculated its budget for the current school year, putting them into a more than $30 million shortfall. The protest is in front of the district offices in Chula Vista. Megan, a lot of stuff going on.
Yeah, another fair weather day today, but things change tomorrow when Santa Ana winds move in. Temperatures today pretty comparable to where we were yesterday, mostly in the low to mid 70s with 60s for some coastal areas, 60s also in the mountains with 80s in our deserts. Tomorrow, warming trend kicks off as Santa Ana winds develop. That's going to scour out the clouds, bring in much drier and windier conditions. In fact, a red flag warning will be in effect most of tomorrow into most of Friday, 10 a.m. Thursday through 10 p.m. Friday. Northeasterly winds 20 to 50 miles per hour for a lot of us, potentially gusts as high as 60 miles per hour or so for some of the windier spots. And humidity levels in the single digits. We are going to see breezy conditions reach all the way to our coastline, though it won't be as windy or as dry as that. Temperatures will be climbing to the mid to upper 70s Friday into next week for our coast. Inland neighborhoods, we're going to be in the 80s then. And offshore winds, Santa Ana conditions are actually going to last into next week. Winds actually will pick up once again late Sunday into Monday. So, of course, we're going to be keeping eyes on that. Prepare your fire plan. Get your kit ready to go just in case. Virginia?
Yeah, really good recommendation. Thanks, Megan. For the latest news, weather, and traffic, just go to 10news.com or you can download our free app from the App Store. For 10 News, I'm Virginia Chaw.